What is the actions class in WebDriver? Actions class is mainly used to handle the mouse and keyboard actions. That means you want to send your actions from keyboard or from mouse to the web page elements or web page. And this class is providing a ready-made methods for us. Those ready-made methods we can use, and you can do action on the web page elements and on the web page basically. And where this class is available? This class is available in main package arg.openqa.selenium.interactions package. This actions class is available. The first method we can discuss here, click method. Click without parameters. This clicks at the current mouse location where the mouse is available. It will click on that place. That's a first click. Second click, click web element on element. So we can say, see that the method name is same, but parameters are changing. So what type of OOPS concept is this?
Method overload.
Method overloading. Method overloading, right? So method name is same, but arguments are changing. So this is the arguments count is increasing here. That's why this is the method overloading concept. You can give example. So method overloading example, you can give these methods. So this click method clicks at the given element where the element is there. On that element it will perform the click action. So one click without parameters will click at the where the mouse is available. Click, if you give web element as a argument, it will perform the click on the element. Next method, click and hold. This clicks and without releasing. It clicks but won't release at the current mouse location. Another click and hold with web element and clicks without releasing in the middle of the given element. The middle of the given element, it performs the click action and it won't release. Then how can we release that? You have to call release method. There is a release method is available. That release method you have to call. If you call click and hold without parameters to release that mouse, you call release without parameters. So this release method releases the depressed left mouse button at the current mouse location. And another click and hold with parameter is there, right? That one, if you use this click and hold with parameters, if you use this method to release this on that element, the depressed left mouse button, you need to call release web element. So this is the methods we need to call to release that depressed left mouse button at the given element. This is the release with web element, and click and hold, and click and hold with web element. And next one is context click. Context click is mainly used to perform a right click operation where the mouse is available. You want to do right click operation like this. So this context click will do that action. And context click of web element on element. So this method will right click on the given element. From element on the element, you want to perform a right click operation. This will help you. So that is the this context click method. And double click. So double click, it performs the double click operation at the current mouse location, and double click on the element, it performs the double click operation at the given element. Next method, drag and drop web element source comma web element target. And basically this method performs the click and hold at the source element and moves the source to target element and releases there. First, you have a movable objects in the web page. You want to move from source to target place. Then you can use this drag and drop method. Both the source and target element, if you know, then you can use a drag and drop method. Or something like that, you want to move based on the X and Y coordinate basis. Then you can use a drag and drop by method. Web element source, comma, int X coordinate, comma, int Y coordinate. You can give, you know, source, but you the target element you want to give in the X and Y coordinate format. Then call drag and drop by method. And this method performs the click and hold at the source element and moves the moves this source element by a given X and Y coordinate location, and then releases the mouse there. So that's a drag and drop by. See that this drag and drop by, three methods combination, this one, drag and drop. See that here the method name also coming, performs click and hold. Who will do click and hold? There is a method right here. Click and hold method is there. And then you need to move this source to target. There is a move to element method is there. So move to element method is there. It moves the cursor from one location to other location. That's what this move to element method also you can use here. And then releases the mouse at the target. So then you have to call release method. So this drag and drop method is three methods combination. One is a click and hold, then another one is a move to element, then third one is release method. They all these three methods combined and created a drag and drop method. Here a drag and drop by also another three methods combination. One is click and hold method. Alternative way how you can do drag and drop by, I'm giving another three methods. Click and hold, first you have to call. Then move by offset method is there. Here is the move by offset method. So what it does is it moves the mouse from current position to given XY coordinates. That's what the move by offset method purpose. And then you need to release at the given location. You can use a release method here also. That's a drag and drop by. And drag and drop is both source and target, you know, then you can use that method. Then you want to press particular key, you can use key down of keys dot key name. It presses the specified key, it won't release. And one more key down is there. So you can press the key after focusing on this element. This key you want to press on this element, then you can use key down of this element. Now you want to release this key, call key up. Key up is going to release that key, keys dot key name, modifies key up web element keys dot key name. So this method releases the key on the element. That's the key down, key up, and overloaded methods. These are all same method twice, but parameters are changing. Move by offset. Move by offset means you can move the mouse from current position to it's a given XY coordinate. And next one is move to element, web element to element. So you want to handle the menus. You have some menus. And you want to move first cursor to that element, then menu will show. Then sub menu if you want to go again. And again move to element. Then you can perform the action on the required menu options. Right? So that menu handling is done completely by this move to element and click method finally. So this is the how we can verify the menus with this move to element method. And next one is move to element, web element to element, int x coordinate and y coordinate. So this method will be helpful for us. Moves the mouse to an x coordinate and y coordinate from top left corner of the element. So it will move the mouse a given xy coordinate. So from current position to that element. That's the move to element you can use. Mainly we are going to use for menu handling purpose. Menu handling purpose we can use this. That's the move to element print method. And another very important one, perform method. Perform method mainly used to finish your action perfectly. We need to use perform method. Every method after you need to call a perform method. Then only the action will be completed successfully. Every method, you have to chain this method. Chaining means this method you are calling, right? After that, you have to call this perform method. And only your action will be completed successfully. Remember this point. So release method we have seen. Release method with web element we have seen. Send keys method. Send keys method, char sequence, dot, dot, dot. Keys to send means multiple characters you can send. These are optional arguments, right? These are optional arguments. How many you want, you can send it. So send keys method is used to send the keys to the active element. Whichever element is active on that element, you can send all the keys with the send keys method. And as any keys, keyboard keys you want to send, like you have a keys up, keys down, arrow down, arrow key, shift key, control key, tab key, escape key, delete key, backspace, home key, anything if you want to send to the particular element, or you can use send keys method. Keys dot, the key name you give, that will go to that element. So another send keys method, particular element you want to send this key, so you can use this send keys method. Web element, element keys dot key name. So this is how we can use send keys method. Then how to use all these methods? These are all non-static methods. So how can we call one class non-static methods?
By creating object of that class.
That's the point. So you need to create object for the class that we learned in the Java. And actions act equal to new actions of driver. It has a parameterized constructor. I'm passing the parameterized constructor value here. And with this object reference, you call the method, whichever the method you want. Then after that, you have to chain this perform method. Every method after, every action method after, you need to call perform method. Mandatorily you need to call. So that's the perform method purpose. Next, build method. You want to perform multiple actions on the same element. Then we can use a build method, generates a composite action containing all actions so far ready to be performed. And you want to just trigger all the actions at a time, you can use a build method. Then on this composite action, you can call perform method to finish the action. So that's the build method. After, you have to call again perform method. The build method will return an action interface. Action interface, it will be written. And how to use this build method is, first create object for actions class. There are two. Actions is different, action is different. Actions is a class, but action is an interface. Okay, so actions, act equal to new actions of driver. And now act dot method one, dot method two, dot method three, dot method four, dot build. So these are all composite actions. You are calling build method. So this build method is returning action interface object. On this composite action, you finally call the perform method. So this is how you can use a build method. If you're doing multiple actions on particular element, you can use a build method. If only one action you are doing, you don't need a build method. Just call directly perform method after that action method. So this is what all actions class methods. And so let's see how to do these things. So we have examples here, jQuery, UI.com. So this one we are using to do our these programs. And another one you can use, Heroku app. So Heroku app website is there, right? This website also you can use to perform the different actions. And you can see a drag and drop. You can see a drag and drop. You can drag and drop here. So this is the source, but we drag and drop it at the target. Or you can do this drag and drop here like that. A is moving to B, B going to source. So this is the drag and drop. You can practice this. Okay, this is the exercise for you, but I will explain here this jQuery UI.com website scenario. So first, what we need to do, we need to land on this web page and click on droppable. You have here internal frame inside, you have a source and target. So this is the source element, drag me to my target is the source, and drop here is the target. So I need to move it. So manually, how we are doing, it's very important. So what I did, I click and hold on the source element, I move to target and releasing there. This is the how we can handle it. So drag and drop method we can use. Next, this we need to automate. Let's automate this. Okay, so we'll create a simple test case. And I'll show you how to do this. We'll take the required ones, okay? The code, you can check that. So I'm creating a testng class, okay? Just take this, right-click on testng and create a testng class. Create testng class. First test case name is drag and drop. Drag and drop test. So we need before class, after class. These two are enough for us. Click on finish. Right? And this is the two things we need. And we need again this common things, right? I'll take up this. Yeah, I'll put it down so that it will be easy for us. Okay. Now, same thing, I'll just copy here. the before class, these two we need. Hard assertions if we need, we'll use, otherwise we will remove that. I want these two. Then same thing, I want before class related code I want. Before class code I want. So what is this before class code? And you can put this entire thing. So before class and after class, I'm just copy pasting here. So what we did, all the browser code we kept in one place. You remember that? So that is what we are going to do here. So which browser you want to run, you can control. You don't need to do. So here particular browser, you don't need to go. That's what I explained yesterday. And same thing we are going to do in the framework. Same code, you're going to repeat that. But here I'm not going to use exe file in the framework. We can eliminate this exe file concept in the framework. Now, first method is drag and drop test. Drag and drop test. Drag and drop test. So what we need to do, first we need to launch the application, right? Launch the application. So driver dot get of the URL. Give the given URL. So which URL? This URL you take it. Okay, then so wait for the page title. Wait for the page title. Driver dot, sorry, wait, right, wait dot until expected conditions dot title contains. See, title contains or title is, you can use. Let's take this, go to, you can find here vpage source or inspect. We need inspect, we'll do inspect and get the page title from the head tag. Inside there is a title tag, look for the title tag, copy that title and paste it here. So if you want, you can do assertion also. If you want, you can do assertion also. Hard asset dot asset equals, and you can give actual value, and expected is what it is. You can give driver dot get title is the actual value. Okay, and that's how you can assert that. Then so we need to switch to the internal frame, right? We have a method here already. So this method I'm going to call switch to the internal frame. So this is inside the internal frame. You can see here. This is inside the internal frame. And you can see here. See that iframe. Iframe, src, and class. So take the class. Iframe, how can we handle? How can we handle the iframe? Utility dot switch to frame. Switch to frame. I have to pass web element. That's a switch to frame web element driver, and we can write web element driver dot find element py dot class name, just give the class value. So one line I'm finishing everything. Okay, so utility method inside this method we already created. So utility class inside we have created a switch to frame method. That method I'm calling here. Okay, I switch it to the frame. Now I need to identify the source and target. Identify the source and target. Let's identify the source and target. Web element source element equal to driver dot find element. So by, let's see which locator it is. Let's load this again to rearrange these elements. So these are the elements. So we came to this internal frame inside now after calling the switch to frame method. Now I need to identify this ID. With ID we can identify this draggable method. Draggable test by dot ID, the ID value. So web element, that one. So identify the target element. Driver dot find element, so by dot ID and ID value. So the target also has ID, so you can say droppable. So source and target we identified. We got source and target values. Now if you want to use a drag and drop method, we need to create object, right? Create object for actions class. So actions act equal to new actions class, and this has a parameterized constructor, so passing the driver as the parameter object. The actions import from org.openqa.cln. Interaction. So this is the code. Now you call the methods, right? We have to drag and drop. So drag the source element to target element, and drag the source element to target element, and release at the target. Okay, now act dot drag, straightforward method, drag and drop method you are calling. So that is a source and then target. After that you need to call perform method. Mandatorily we need to call perform method to finish the task, So if you want to observe, just give some thread dot slip, otherwise it will close immediately, because we are calling in the after class method that quit method, right? So that it will close. That's why we need to call that sleep. So I'll just give 2 seconds, right? 2 seconds I'm giving. Just call this add throws declaration. So I have the parameter here. I need to give browser value. So I need to create a testng suit file. How to create testng suit file? Right click on the class testng, convert to testng. So I'll give the my suit name actions suit, and xml file location I'll change. Xml file location, I'll select my project src, then target testng programs package. Under that I'm creating my actions testng, actions testng dot xml. So I'm not running anything parallel mode, I don't need any thread count, so my class has come already here. Click on finish. So now I need to give a parameter value, right? Which browser you want to run. So go to actions testng dot xml, open the xml file, and in the test tag below you just give parameter tag. So parameter name is a browser and value is a, I'll run on the Chrome browser. So that's it. Now you right click and run as a testng suit. So the test case will run on this Chrome browser. It will do drag and drop. See that? Drag and dropped already. So this is the how you can check drag and drop is working or not. Same thing. So what I'm going to do here is I will not use a direct method. So another way how to do drag and drop, I'll show you now. First, move the cursor to, so click and hold the source. We need to click and hold the source element, right? That I need to do. Act dot act is the object reference of actions class. Click and hold of source. Click and hold of source element. So you give the source element. But you have to call perform method on each action class method. Then move the cursor to target element. Right? You have to move the source to target. Move the source to target. Move the source element meant to target element. How can we do that? Act dot move to element. So target, just give the target dot perform method. So then I need to release that. So release the mouse at target element. So act dot release method dot perform method. See that? So every action method after, I'm chaining the perform method. This is called method chaining. Perform method is mandatorily you need to call to finish this release action, to finish this move to element action, to finish this click and hold action perfectly, we need to use this. These three methods combination is this drag and drop. Either you can call straightforward method or you can use these three methods to do a drag and drop. So now right click and run it, whether it is doing or not. Let's see that. Drag and drop is working or not. With the three methods, drag and drop, we can check. Done. You can see that source is moved to target. So this is the another. So way I have used all the methods. Please catch that. That's important. First, I use a drag and drop and perform method. All actions class methods how to use, I'm showing here. Next, click and hold, move to element, release. Almost we used five methods here itself. Okay. So next one, drag and drop by demo, I'll show you. Drag and drop by demo, I'll show you. So I'll just copy this and I'll paste it so that we can save the time. Okay. This method is not going to work on the Chrome browser. There is an issue with the Chrome browser. You will get a different exception you will get, but I'll show you that exception. Then I will switch to other browser. Drag and drop by test. Drag and drop by test. I'm just copy pasting. Drag and drop by. First one is a drag and drop, and this one is a drag and drop by. Drag and drop by test. So this also changes. Draggable will come. The URL will be a draggable. So there is a draggable is there, right? This one. This URL will come. So take this and give this URL, change this URL. So only test method I'm changing. And even it will change here, draggable. PPA, OPPA instead of OPPA, just put DRAGGAL. DRAGGAL, draggable. That's it. Remaining everything same. See that here also. Everything is same, only you have a source. So you need to identify the source element. You have to switch to frame first. That anyhow we have switched already. Switch to frame is done and we have switched. Then draggable, so this element. So we have already draggable. Yeah, this is the source element. This one we are not using. This target we don't have. Target we don't have here. You can see that. We don't have a target here. But you can move here and there. Based on XY coordinates, you can move here and there. That's it. Other than that, nothing. Right? That's a moving here, X and Y coordinate basis, you're moving. So that's the source element. You're moving to X coordinate and Y coordinate basis. Now, the first method is drag the source element based on X and Y coordinate and release here. Okay? Drag and drop by. So drag and drop by method, you drag and drop by method we have to use. So target we don't know, right? Target we don't. I'll comment out all this. Shift control forward slash. It will comment out, right? At a time you can comment out all of them. Now, we don't know x coordinate and y coordinate. I'm giving approximately, okay? 120, the x coordinate, and 150, y coordinate I'm giving. So let's see whether it is going to do this drag and drop or not. Now, you need to call this class inside this XML file, right? So only you have a drag and drop test, but we don't have drag and drop by test. So you write class tag. So class name is test-ng-programs. And I need to comment out this, right? How can I don't want to run both. I'll comment out this. How to comment an XML tag, exclamatory mark, this one, two hyphens, and this one you can put in that at the end. That's it. So then it will comment out. So this is the how to comment an XML tags. So I'm covering here one more concept, how to comment an XML tag. So this class I am not running now. I'm running only this class in a suit file. Right click and run as test-ng suit. So you will get an exception here. Chrome browser is starting. You will get an exception. See that fail code. And this bug, I think they haven't fixed it. Remember this. You can tell this. Move target out of bounds exception. Move target out of bounds exception you're getting. What is the exception name? Move target out of bounds exception. So this issue is available in the Chrome browser. Chrome browser, this issue is there. They're not fixing this issue. Move target out of bounds exception issue is there. So when you're running actions drag and drop by method and you're not able to run in the Chrome browser. So then that is throwing move target out of bounds exception. Now same thing will work if you run on the Firefox. Just change it to Firefox. See, this issue is solved there. Right click, other browsers it is working. Only Chrome browser, that is issue. That kind of problems you will face. But this is the Selenium side issue. It's not our coding issue. So say browser is launched and Chrome Firefox browser is launched here and it's going to open the jQueryui.com/draggable and then it will move the cursor. See that already moved, done. So it's moved, passed now. You don't have any issues here. You can see that no exceptions, nothing, it's completed. So that's the Firefox browser. You can run your test cases successfully. But what other actions you can use other than this drag and drop by? Same, you comment out this and uncomment, right? Uncommented. Now click and hold is same, click and hold source, but here move by offset will come here. So what is the method? Move by offset method. You have to give x coordinate and y coordinate. I'm giving 120 dot perform and release the method. So release at, so wherever the mouse is there, mouse is available here, there you release it dot perform. Again, three methods combination is this drag and drop by. Drag and drop by means click and hold, move by offset. Before we used a move to element, right? If you know source and target. Now we don't know target. So we are moving this source by given x and y coordinate basis. And then there I am releasing the mouse. So this is the another way to do click and hold and move to element, move to the x, y coordinate basis and release there. So this is the another way. See, browser we are controlling from XML file, which browser you want to run. Yesterday I have explained, please go through that video and practice that. See that it moved down. Basically it will be on the top. It moved down that many X and Y coordinate basis. It is moving down. Okay. So these are the few methods we have used already. See, click and hold, perform method, drag and drop by, and move by offset, release method. So these are all the different methods of actions class I'm just showing here. So let's see what other scenario we can do next. So we will do multiple actions. So multiple actions will do multiple actions on LinkedIn page. So copy this. I'll just take this and paste it. I'll explain here. So multiple actions means basically I'm going to call all the browsers. So this browser code we need to change. This one before class I need to change. Anyhow, assertions we are not using. Remove the assertions. If you're using, you can keep. Otherwise, you can remove this. So exe files will be different. That's why I'm not. I'll remove this because I'm not using here. So the no actions we are using, no assertions we are using. That's why I'm removing that. Because here the Gecko driver is changed and this Chrome driver exe path is changed. That's why we need to copy paste this. Okay. Let me explain what this composite actions test. So multiple actions I'm doing on particular element. Basically, I'm opening the linkedin.com. So it's already opened here. You can see here. It's open and I am going to the sign in page. Then I'm identifying here. First, I'll click on this. I'll perform a click action on this edit box. Then I'll press the shift key. First, I'll click on this edit box. Click action I will do. Then I'll press the shift key on this element. Then I'll type. If you press the shift key and typing in lowercase, it will type capital letter, right? So this is what it is going to happen. And then I'm going to release that shift key. I need to release the shift key because my work is done. I want to release that shift key. I'll release that shift key with the key up. First, to press the shift key on this element, I'll call the key up. And to key down, I'll use to press the shift key. To release that key, I'll use key up method. Then I will double click on that so that it will select. Then I'll right click on that element. See, this multiple actions we are doing on the same element. Then we have to use a build method. That build method release returns a composite action composite action, and that you call perform method to finish all your tasks perfectly. That's what we are doing here. Remember this, what all we are doing? First, click action. So see that. So I'm identifying the email edit box. Okay, I'm identifying the email edit box, then creating actions. So I think here we have to give home. That's how URL is changed now. I'm using driver.navigate method.to of URL and verifying the page title and click on the sign in link and wait for the sign in login page title. Then identify the email edit box. Create object for actions class. Actions act equal to new actions of driver. Any action class method you want to call, we need to create an object. Why? Because all the methods in this class are non-static methods. So that's why if you want to call any actions class method, first create object, object reference dot click method. I'm clicking on the email edit box. Dot one more method I'm calling on the same element. Key down keys dot shift key. Shift key I'm pressing on the email edit box. Dot send keys. Send keys we are typing purpose, right? So send keys email edit box on the email edit box. I'm typing this Selenium key. Selenium keyword I'm typing here. Then I'm releasing the shift key. So my work is done. See, I'm typing here lowercase. Because of shift pressed on this element, it will type in capital letter. That's a concept. And key up keys dot shift and dot double click email edit box and dot context click. Context click, what it will do? I told you it will perform the right click operation. So mouse is on this element, right? So it will right click on that element. Dot build. So this build method You can use, if you are calling like this, multiple actions, class methods you are calling, at the end you call build method, so that this method will return a action interface and that composite action reference. Now on this composite action, you call the perform method to finish the action perfectly, it will be called. So just call this on this actions, this suit file. So I'm commenting out this method, and I'll just put this like this. So then you can add another, you can run all of them if you want, okay? So there is no issue. Test ng program, so the package name, right? Package name dot the class name, give the class name. Now I'm running only one test case. You can run as a suit also. So now right click on this suit file and run as test ng suit. If you have XML file, that's a suit file you're running, okay? Now the Firefox browser will open, and it will open the linkedin.com website, and it will perform the click action and sign in link. Yeah, and it will come here. See, first press it, double click, done. At a time, all actions are done. So that's the, see, the test case is passed. And this is another test case. I covered most of the methods here. You can observe here. Click method, key down, send case method, key up, double click, context click. So almost all the methods we have covered here. Any queries here? I want to open my any element in the new tab or new window. How can we open? And another one, we'll do menu actions first. Menus will do, how to handle menus. Then we'll go for the, let me show you that menus related. Here you have menu, click on menu, link on the left panel. Then you can see I'm just mouse overing here. I don't need to click, mouse over, then you will get a next menu. Again, mouse over, next menu you will get. Then final one, I want to click it. This is the one. Otherwise you go to any website, right? Any website, or even Salesforce also. Any website you go, you just mouse over on these tabs, and you can click on that, right? You can click on that. So, right, products, and you can click on whatever you want. So, whatever the option you want to choose, first mouse over on the products, then click on customer 360 link. Just again, customer 360 also, you have to mouse over first, then you click on it. Then only it will help you. Then only you will land in this space. Then you can verify this page title or some element here. This you can verify, right? This heading, the header. And that's the how you can handle this menus. Okay, so you take up this, and I'll help you here how to do menu, all these things. Okay, so this how to do, I'll show you. See that everything, I need to switch to this, then I can do mouse over on that. Each move to element method you need to call, move to music element, then you are getting the rock menu, sub menu, again rock sub menu, again rock sub menu, you mouse over, again you will get alternative or classic sub menu. So you move to the classic sub menu, then you will click on this, finally you will click on this. So this is the kind of actions we are going to do that. So how to do this, I'll show you here. Okay, so this is the one test case. So let's, simple thing, I'll just take up from here. First scenario you need to understand, then what are the methods. So I'll take up this before class from here, because the exe files are changing, that's why we need to change that. So assertions we don't need, just remove them. Okay, now before class and after class we have done, or you can use before test also, so no issues. Before test also you can take. Now, so menu handling test, so what we are doing, we are opening the URL driver.get. I'm handling one more concept here, soft asset class I'm calling. So till now we have seen a hard assertions, right? Here I'm going to show you soft assertions. What is meant by soft assertions? Soft assertion will help you. You will do multiple verifications. If any one verification fails, the program won't stop there. It will continue execution of next lines of code. And at the end, you need to call assert all method. It will assert all the assertions. Any one assertion fails, it will catch that assertion and it will report for us. That's the soft assert means. So soft assert class is there, like hard assertions class is there, right? Same way, soft assert class is there. Create object for soft assert, new soft assert. I'm creating object for soft assert class. Then open the menu URL and wait for this menu URL and validating with the assert true. Driver.get pay source dot contains the driver.get title. This title is there in this source code or not. I'm verifying with this assert true soft assert and web element. So we don't need to do this, right? I can call directly. All right, I can call directly. So utility class utility dot switch to method you need to call. So this and that is done. And this one you have to call this iframe element. That's it. Done. So you are switching to the iframe. Then create object for actions class. Actions act equal to new actions of driver. Then first identify the music menu. This is the music menu. You identify this. You can see right click, inspect. So you get a UID 9. Then rock also you have UID 10. Rock also, you see that UID 10 is there. So UID 10. All these elements I am identifying. Then classic, you identify this. So all UID 12 is there. So this is the one by one I'm identifying. I'm moving to that element. See that identified music menu. Then I'm asserting sa.assert to true. This music menu is displayed or not, I'm checking. If not displayed, I'm saying music menu is not available. Then act.move to element music menu.perform method. So click on the perform method on this move to element. Then rock submenu I'm identifying and same way waiting for this element is visible, rock submenu, and I'm asserting the rock submenu is displayed in the piece or not. Act dot move to element rock submenu dot perform. See, move to element only you are calling. Each menu submenu you have to mouse over there, then next submenu will show it to you. Then classic submenu. So web element classic submenu, wait dot until expected conditions dot visibility of classic submenu, then assert dot assert true class sub classic submenu is displayed or not. Then act dot move to element, then act dot click at the end. I am clicking on that dot perform. Then sa dot assert all mandatory you need to call at the end assert all. So you have done multiple soft assertions here, right? Multiple soft assertions you have done. Any assertion might fail, right? So that's why at the end you call sa.assert all method you need to call. Remember this soft assertions and then call the method. So tomorrow I'll show you. Just run this quickly. We can close for the day. And I'll just call this one. I'm commenting out. So next one class tag. So test ng programs dot menu handling, run this. Testng programs, correct, right? Yeah. Now right click on the actions testng suit file, run this. So browser is launched and the menu, see menu URL is opened. See that it is handling that. That's it. So this is how to handle menus. Anywhere same code, you don't need to write a separate, but number of submenus are based on that last option you have to click. Remember that point. Okay, so this is another thing they will ask you in the interview, how to handle menus. So the same code you can write it. Yeah, so that's it for the day. And tomorrow we'll see a few more concepts. Thank you.